Kia ora team, welcome to another mission. I thought I'd kickstart this one off slightly different because I need to explain a couple of things to put this video into context. The first being this thing here, this logo, this thing called the Brothers of Bubu or Bobs, you might have heard me make reference to in a number of my other vids. The Brothers of Bubu are a closed Facebook group of 100 members, and to get into the group you basically have to search for the title Gav Bubu on Facebook. And in there, once you apply, you have to answer three questions really, really well. And then if you make it to the shortlist and we think you're a pretty cool sort of chap or girl, we'll then tag you in. You'll have to watch the 10 rules, and those 10 rules are really based around respect and expectation of your behavior on the page. Basically, if you're going to be a troll, this is not the page for you. And then you'll have to do a video introducing yourself, and that's quite an important part of it, because our members like to see who they're dealing with. And if you don't have the sort of courage or the short and curlies to put yourself on video and talk about yourself, like the rifles you use, what made you get into hunting and what you might get out of the page, well then there's no need for you to apply. So that's the Brothers of Bubu, and you hear me talk about them, nickname them called Bobs. Those are the people I kick with, that's the group I belong to. The second thing I'd like to explain is the young lady that's coming with us on this trip. Her name is Courtney Pellow. She comes from Auckland. She traveled a long way on this mission to get down to have a catch up with myself and young Craig Paton, who's also a brother of Bubu. Her goal is to shoot her first Ruahine Red deer, and that was our mission, was to help her get there. She is also the one and only female brother of Bubu that we have currently. We call her a shebop. So the whole mission is really based around trying to get Courtney onto a deer. The third and final thing I want to clarify is the location we were hunting. This is actually public land. We're actually walking in on dog track. Though when you see it, it kind of looks like it's on farmland, but it's not. It's actually technically and legally public dock land. There's a farm right behind us, and also there's a bit of logging going on in one of the areas as well. But the areas we were shooting on are legitimate, is legitimate public hunting land. You would have seen this particular spot on a number of other sort of famous sort of local YouTubers. They hunt there a lot as well, and that was the whole reason going there, because this place is pretty much a honey hole. We really need to guarantee a deer for Courtney. So that's all I need to explain. Let's get this mission on the way. Get to the car park, get some packs loaded up, and we're into it.
Clueless, you got me clueless. See, I don't know what it is, but you have it. When you started moving, don't stop moving. Let me get closer to you, closer to you. Closer, closer. This night is overdue. I can't help myself. One thing I wanna do is get closer to you, closer to you, closer.
So we've just pulled up off the track, just out of the car park. Rookie move again, forgot to do the safety status. We want to be advocating safety all the time. My rifle is attached to my pack. It has got no mag on. The bolt's in. Courtney's, your one is
attached to the pack.
Yep.
Bolt in, and mag is in the pack.
Mag is in the pack. Sweet. Yours, bro?
No bolt, no mag.
Okay, no bolt, no mag. No idea. I'm a meat. Time is 2 o'clock. We are set up with our fly, got our bedding all sussed out. Just gonna maybe have ourselves a cup of tea and wander on out to the blind. The blind's about 10 minutes that way. It's got a bit of a whoopy breeze into it, so make sure we're nice and warm when we get out there. Cup of tea first, and we're away. Where are we off to, Courtney?
We're shooting.
Let's go shoot a deer. A good bow?
Yeah, bro.
You go here. I need to make sure my rifle doesn't get too much.
Now, please don't get me wrong, because I love what I do, but I am only human. I got problems just like you. Some days I just wanna get up, pack up and go home. I've come too far to turn around and let it all go. That's not the way that I was brought up. 'Cause I just can't give up now. See, I've got all of these people, they depend on me somehow.
Half past four. And this right here, we've only got about another 25 minutes of daylight left. This is sexy time, so stand by. Here they come.
I feel so privileged to have the gift of music. I understand that it don't work when I start to abuse it. Now I know.
Let's just be settling up for a bit of a bite to eat. We've got, what are these? We've got garlic naan bread, the infamous John Shannon Kranskis. We got, I don't know what she's doing over there.
But, last.
But anyway, what we're basically saying that this is a maple syrup free zone. Yeah, deep boiled hard. She's got her night face on. Just took the cucumbers out. Eh? That's us. We've had a good bite to eat. A couple of glasses of port. And reflecting on today and planning for tomorrow. We'll be up at 5 o'clock. Have a bite to eat. And then wander down to our blind, get set up in the dark. And hopefully, fingers crossed, we'll have better fortune tomorrow. Hey, Courtney. Yeah. There's a bit of moisture around. I managed to get right down the leaky end. It'll be brewful in the morning. All good. Anyway, that's us. We'll see you in the morning. Good morning. And look at that. Bloody fail. Absolutely soaked. From the inside. Outside's dry. Inside saturated. I don't know what's going on, man. Fucking saturated. Like a fucking tap. I'm gonna have to give this bivy bag to visitors now. Jeez, a 5 o'clocker. Time to get up. That was one very wet night. That pissed down me.
It absolutely hoofed down.
Yeah.
I didn't get to sleep till about midnight.
And then it was went nothing from about, I don't know, 1 o'clock onwards. Yeah. But have a bite to eat and then wander on down to the blind. Pretty bloody windy. Bang on. Near enough 6 o'clock. Gear's ready. Missy Tero up there. She's all ready to rock and roll. And Chinese laundry in here because I've got a wet sleeping bag thanks to that fucking expensive plastic bag. I'm going to make a call out to YouTube land. Can someone please help me figure out how to not have an internal shower when I sleep in one of those things? Fuck. Rab, storm, bivy bag. Yeah. I know this sounds a bit repetitive, but our safety status of our weapons / firearms is what for you, Mr. Peyton?
Bolts in, magazine is in, nothing out the chamber, and I got my safety on.
Miss Pellow?
Bolts in, mag's not in.
Alright, cool. And mine is the same. Bolt in, no mag, strip to side of te tonka pack. So we've arrived at the blind. It is probably pumping anywhere from 10 to 15 mile an hour. Just getting our gear squared away, and we've just popped off that cool blind just up here. Pull off the top of the ridge and calm down, get some gear squared away, and then as daylight sort of pops over wall, head up, eh, bro? Just a wee bit of an update. Got up here, set up, and started getting glasses on the hills over here, and then I don't know, so just started getting a bit lighter. Two hinds sort of guessed down through here and then straight across there. I'm taking it they must have winded us, so bit of a bugger, because they must have been standing up there for a wee bit looking at us and then caught a whiff of us and phew, see you later. But it's 8:45, so the deer generally will, I don't know, feed out most of the day and pop out most of the day in the Ruahine. So that's my experience anyway, so we'll just keep be vigilant and get all our munchies in our bags and cookers and whatnot, so well stocked, well supplied. But it is bloody cold. Yeah, big yellow thing up in there's decided to make a bit of an appearance, eh? Sun's out, deer's out, stand by. Next bit of footage will be on a deer. Is it? I just thought she was a bit sort of whitish. On her first atmosphere. Oh no, she's a red. Iron music is here in the air. Oh, that's good to see one. Let's collaborate over this beautiful so thing. We're waiting to see some deer that the clag's cleared. I'm just gonna leave him to spot because he's got a deadly set of ice, and then I'm gonna ask this girl some questions. Yeah, oh no, all right. So the first question is, Courtney Pellow, what made you want to get into hunting?
Oh, people are, that's like the one question everyone always asks me, and
because you don't kind of fit the profile, bro.
No, I think just being like a bit of a curious, adventurous person by nature.
Yep.
And hearing about it, it seemed like kind of the perfect package of,
outdoors, adventure.
Yeah, everything.
What would be the biggest kick you get out of this stuff, like deer hunting and stuff like that? What's the biggest thing, biggest takeaway for you? You enjoy out of it the most?
Probably just pushing myself.
Yep.
Being in the hills, seeing how far I can push myself and what I can find. You know, less I guess.
I gotta say, we had to slow it down last night. You were sprinting up that dirty big hill up there. And she was.
We were sweating
our asses off trying to keep up with her.
I slow down when it gets like
that. She was away. So, how long have you been hunting for?
Just over a year.
Just over a year. How many deer you shot?
Four or five.
Yeah.
Something like that.
I know fellas that have been hunting for like maybe 5 or 6 years and they've only shot one deer. Courtney's also a she-bob or brother of Bubu, the only one we've got so far. We've had a couple other girls come and go, but she seems to be one that still hanging in there by the skin of her teeth. So that's our she-bob, that's ex-Courtney, and hopefully, fingers crossed, this afternoon we might have tag a deer.
Yeah, I hope so.
All right. So we've got one at 680 meters. He definitely fed out, so we're gonna try and get up, set up to have a shot. So stand by. 20.9, Courtney. you got clay coming into.
Yep, we'll take the right one. No hold, just straight on it.
Yeah.
Ready? On my count. One, two.
That just came in. Man, shot something up the butt.
Well, well, we got three members of the Missy Tero Club now.
We're all carrying the rubbish out.
I'm not the president, though. I'm a new member. But we had a good look at the footage, and we had there's no wounded deer. Clearly, no wounded deer, but. There was a wind hold that, be honest, there's three of us looking at this, looking, feeling, hearing, all that sort of stuff, and there was no indication. We thought there was zero wind down there. Even the scrub's a bit thick to actually pick up any wind indicators, but it was recalculating based off the distance missed, which was about half a meter for me. At the 680, we're calculating, guesstimating it was anywhere from sort of 10 to maybe 13. Mile an hour was the one we didn't even see, didn't even calculate. So, but what was good is her shot and his shot were basically right next to each other at the deer. So, elevation good, Windage bad, windage very, very bad. Yeah, I blame not one on myself, I blame all three of us. Yeah, but and as you can see, the clags come in, and guess which way the clag came from. That way. Which way we missed? That way. But anyway, we're going to have a cup of tea and drown our sorrows. But I'll tell you, we're here for the rest of the day. We won't make that rookie error again.
She just toppled over. I just saw those
legs. And there it is. Our she bob has smoked it. Can you shoot him, brother?
Stop, Courtney. Well done. Congratulations.
Yes. Yay. That was such a satisfying.
Yeah, you both tweaked it like a good couple of good hits. Yeah, there it is. Righty. Time is 20 past. Three, we'll make a bit of a call. We're just gonna go get Courtney's deer. And we were gonna kind of sit up here and maybe bag another one, but that's us. We're gonna pack all our gears up, take a single pack down, stash all our gear in here somewhere, and go get Missy's deer. Last name, not Tettle.
Flow along with me. Low light. That's when it's looking better tonight. When we get some time together, flow along with me. And now I know.
So we've got a bit of a processing line here. The bro's whipping those off. I'm gonna go and bone out, or I'll show you. Courtney, come with me. Because the thing is about trying to keep the meat as clean as possible, so Courtney doesn't have to clean too much shit off it when she goes back to Auckland. But I'll just do a bone out over here.
Oh, your river, how it flows so deep.
Here's, what's that? What's in there?
Two front legs and two back legs.
Yep, sweet ass. All boned out. Get our pack stuff squared away, and we're up that hill.
That's my decision. We're floating up to oblivion. We go.
Hunters will be hunters. And instead of packing up our gear and going up that dirty big hill there, we're gonna go ask for more gear. We got no rifle set up, so we'll pack up in about another when it gets a bit darker, and then hit the hill and head up to camp.
Hoping. I hope in your soul you have a place for me.
And that's us. That's my team over there. Good effort to this lady. Fantastic job, mate. Fucking fantastic job. Hearty as. So we got a bit of celebration going on. We managed to pull a few beers up here, and we'll be taking those rubbish out with us. Got a few nuts there. We're gonna have fresh spiker. Was it a spiker?
Yeah.
Spiker deer heart tonight. I'm just gonna lightly marinate that, slice it up real thin, and give it the super hot sizzle over there. We're gonna have wraps there and deer bacon. Maybe a pudding later on. Well, good morning. That was another very, very wet night. On the call, it's pretty much Tarp City, I would say. But I again had a very terrible sleep. Unfortunately, my rare bivvy bag did the same, and I tried to change a few things around, but it didn't work. Massive condensation, so certainly we'll be looking to probably never use that again, to be honest with you. Yeah, the old packing up with wet shit, it's not fun, eh? Everything's wet, and then you got to get out of your warm gears, get into walking out gears. So we've got our camp sort of just about ready to be all broken down and bedding's all away. It's our campsite, nice and clear. Black seeds. Bit of black seeds to get us on the way home. Rifle status for you before we head off, Bo, is what?
No mag, bolts and nothing up the chamber.
Yep. Courtney?
Bolton, mags out.
Mags out, nothing Bolton, strapped to the pack. I'm summer. Bolton, no mag. That's us. There could be a spot where we maybe quickly detach a rifle and shoot a deer on the way out, but it'll be rock, paper, scissors between those two, because I'm not going to go get a wet up. Anyway, that's us. We're going to get our boogie on, hustle on, and get up the track.
Oh yeah.
And we are back at the truck. Well done, team. Well done. Well. There it is. We'll start with a bit of a recap on our last team. What their thoughts are from the trip, starting with the bro, Craig. Learnings, observations, feeling about the trip, bro?
Always learnings. No particular ones on this time, but there's a lot of things I've been watching with wifey's, Roger's shooting project process. So watching him and taking a few things back for myself. Best thing about this trip was our mate here tagging her first Ruahine deer. Awesome. I'm just so glad to be a part of it, and I hope you enjoyed yourself.
Yeah. Bro, have you any shout outs you want to do?
John Shannon, mate, those Kranskis, they always get us the fuel for the recovery.
And our thanks, bro, awesome. And our guest of honour, Courtney.
Hello.
Yeah. Mate, trip, sum the trip up for you, learnings and whatnot.
Oh, so much. Just been cutting my teeth on bush stalking, so first time ever doing long range shooting, full days glassing, and yeah, just learned so much from these two, dialing in their techniques, how to even shoot a deer long range.
Oh, that's awesome. Good. Yeah, that's
been also boning out on the field. Yeah. Good one.
What about shout outs, mate? Any shout outs you wanna do?
Yeah, shout out NZDA Auckland. Anyone in the area, you should come along. And also Chase and Gather, Michael. Check it out on Instagram, YouTube.
Yeah. Oh, that's cool, mate. Well, I'm glad you enjoyed yourself. And for me, every mission's cool, but this was really special because she's one of the Brothers of Bubu. She's an Elshi Bob. And it was a pleasure to bring her into the Ruahines to tag her first day. And always good working with my bro over here with the shooting process. He's just getting better and better. That's all I got to say. It's probably one of the best, wettest trips. Learned a lot about, obviously, back into hunting in the rain, preparing our camp in the rain. Obviously, one of us has got an issue with a bivy bag, but we'll take that up later. But anyway, I'd just like to thank my mate right here, Courtney, for coming along, and my bro, as usual. I hope you guys enjoyed that mission. Like and subscribe, and we will catch you on the next one. You'll see, you get the best of me.